Should you mod your Tacoma and what to consider? Well, good morning, everybody. How are you today? Pretty good here. So should you mod your Toyota Tacoma and what should you consider? You know, first of all, before we get rolling here, let me tell you something, because I've had a few comments. People ask me, why do you wear sunglasses when you're making movies? Well, because I don't want you to see where I'm looking. Pretty distracting if we see my eyes looking off that way or up that way. It's a YouTuber little trick, right? That way I can see my notes on the board in front of me in case I get lost. But anyway, back to the topic at hand. Should you mod your Tacoma? There are a few things to consider. You know, and I see these floating around out there in comments all the time. A lot of times, false information, right? Number one, warranty. You know, if you just got that brand new shiny Tacoma, you know, like this one right here, you have to consider warranty, right? I mean, you've got 3-year bumper to bumper in case anything goes wrong. And the last thing you want to do is have a major failure. Take your truck in expecting it to be fixed, and the dealer says, no, because you did that, we're not going to cover it because it's your fault. But there's a little caveat to this, right? And the general rule, and this is a general rule, is whatever fails on your Tacoma has to directly be caused by something that you did for it not to be covered. So, I'll give you an example. Let's say that your shock in the front fails, right? It breaks. It doesn't work anymore. The left side of your truck just starts to lean down, right? And obviously, the shock needs to be replaced. But you, as a modding enthusiast, have changed out the taillights on the back of your Tacoma, right? Now, that doesn't mean that the dealer can say, well, because you put new taillights on the back, we're not covering that shock down there. That's not the way it works. One has nothing to do with the other. There is no case that says that because you put a light on the back of your truck, they don't have to cover that shock. It doesn't work that way. So for anybody out there that tells you that if you do anything to your truck, you're gonna void the entire warranty, they are incorrect. Now, I will say, if the wiring, for example, to that back taillight quits working and you've put a new taillight in other words, messed with the connector, then you might have a problem. They're probably not going to cover that part of the warranty because you did something that could have directly affected that wiring. That's kind of loosely how it works. Number two, looks versus function. You know, a lot of people out there, and they like to give you a hard time. Well, you did this. I'll give you another example. The side steps. You know, these things right down here. I had a comment just today. Well, did you ever think that having those hang down low like that might cause problems if you go off-roading? Well, no kidding. Do you think I was born today? Of course I realized that. Might give you a little bit of a clue as to what my plans are with the truck, right? Obviously, it depends on what you're going to do. If you're an extreme heavy-duty off-roader driving over tree stumps and rocks sticking out all over the place, then obviously you don't want to put Predator side steps that hang down on your Tacoma because you think they look good. You have to consider function as well, because for you, they're not going to function very well if you're constantly banging them up against things, right? So you have to consider looks versus function, right? Don't put things on that are going to impede what you plan to do with the truck. On the flip side, don't worry about what other people think you should be doing with your truck. In this example, if you're never going to go off-road in those type of conditions, it doesn't matter. Number three, patience. Patience. This applies if you mod your own truck, right? If you're not a patient person, I wouldn't even think about doing it. What I'm talking about is mods take time. If you're in a hurry and you want it done in 3 seconds, you probably shouldn't attempt it, right? You need to allot in my case, probably double or triple the amount of time because I'm filming. But you have to allot a lot of time to do these things because sometimes things go wrong, right? If you break the head off of a bolt, if you can't get a bolt out, maybe you have to run to Lowe's and buy a different tool or some different fasteners because you didn't have what you need. Don't cut corners. Be patient. All mods, most mods, that are quality are going to work on your truck. It doesn't mean they might not need a little bit of finagling. You know, I put some headlight covers on my mother's new Jeep Gladiator Mojave the other day. And in doing so, I got the thing on there and it didn't fit right. My screw wouldn't reach. Well, it's because there's a little nub that sticks out that you kind of had to push that guard just a little, and I mean just a little bit to the right, and then it pushed all the way in and you screwed it on. Now, if you weren't patient and you stuck that puppy on there, you might have given up. Who knows what you might have done? Maybe you'd have forced it and even broke your headlight. Don't do that. Be patient. Number four, know how. You know, there are plenty of vids out there that can teach you how to do things. Selfishly, I would refer you to my vids on my channel. I've done pretty much all the popular mods that you can do with a Toyota Tacoma, right? But you have to have some know-how, right? And you can get that from the web. Go out, watch videos, look at the instruction manual, make sure you understand what you're doing. Know how the tools that you have function, right? And along with that, use the right tools. You know, if it calls for a Phillips head screwdriver, don't try to jam a smaller flathead in there. It might work, but chances are it's probably going to round out the head of your screw, and you're never going to get that thing out. It helps to have a little bit of know-how, and you can get that from places like the web, even those groups out there, if you can sort through all the trash that's in them, and the instruction manuals. Number five, trade-in. Your truck is going to be worth more if you put mods on it and trade it in because that dealer is going to be drooling over your truck, right? They're going to love all that stuff that you put on just as much as you do. And it's going to be worth the same amount of money you paid. That is all false. You know, most dealers would prefer that you bring a truck in stock, right? Because that's going to appeal to the most number of people. When you start adding mods, you start shrinking down that buying pool, right? Because not everybody, and I know it's hard to believe, not everybody's going to love the mods that you put on, right? They probably were specific to you. So it doesn't help your cause to take it in. And don't ever think that you're going to get the money out of those mods that you put into them at trade. Matter of fact, you might even get dinged for having those on. Your truck might be worth less. And number six, what if you lease? If you lease, you can't mod your Toyota Tacoma. Well, this is a gray area. First of all, that's not true. You can mod it, but remember, you don't own it. You need to return that truck the same way that it was when you borrowed it, because that's what you're doing, right? Or rented it. You're renting it. You're leasing it. You don't own it. When they get that truck back, they want it to be the same way that it was when they gave it to you, right? Minus minor wear and tear and that kind of thing. You know, the example I'll give you there is if you're renting an apartment, right? I mean, can you go in there and tear out a wall, redo the kitchen? Will they let you do that? No, they're not going to let you do that. You don't own it. As long as you put mods on that you can remove, in this case, bolt-on types, put the original parts back on. So that means you have to have a pile somewhere, you know, like I do, of parts that you can reinstall when your lease term is up because they don't want that truck back changed. Anyway, I just wanted to get on here, kind of talk about some things that I see floating out there on the web, some misinformation or false things that all the experts out there love to tell you, I guess. Leave a comment. Let me know if you agree. Also, real quick, if you're interested, I have two other channels. The first is Rob Motive JT, all about my new, to me, 2020 Jeep Gladiator. And Rob Motive Civic, all about my experiences with the Honda Civic Type R and the Honda Civic Sport hatchback. Check them out if you like them. Please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.